This video is dedicated to some of the worst skincare products I have ever used. Let's go. Let's just start with the COSRX pimple patches. Let me read to you what they claim to do. It says, acts as a protective cover, is non-drying, and absorbs impurities and oil. It indeed acts as a protective layer. It stops bacteria from getting into the pimple. It sticks pretty well. Non-drying, haven't noticed any dryness. And absorbs impurities and oil. After a few hours of wearing them, I did notice a slight discoloration, which means it has absorbed something, but I think it only absorbed the oil, because I have used it on several different kind of pimples, like very dry pimples and just red pimples. And you would think that while it says that it absorbs impurities, that if you have a ripe pimple, it will absorb the impurities, but it does nothing. I have noticed a brightening effect that kind of reduced redness, but it didn't really do anything about the pimples. I've heard a lot of great things about it, but it was just very disappointing. Hasn't done anything, honestly. I've used all of the patches, all 24, and I just didn't notice a slight difference. Next up, this is, I think, the biggest disappointment, because it's by The Ordinary. I've heard a lot of great things about the brand, and I personally also love the brand. I love all of the products that I've used, but not this. It is the Moisturizing Factors Plus Hyaluronic Acid. It's a surface hydration formula. Directions say, apply after serums as needed for effective surface hydration. Let me tell you, I had so much trust in this brand that I ordered the bigger version of a product. Could also have ordered 50 milliliters. Now I went to 100 because I was so sure it would be amazing. So the first time I used it, I used it just on its own, but I also used like a lot of setting powder while doing my makeup, and I used a facial cleanser that was actually a little bit too drying, so I basically messed up my skin. But I didn't really know what exactly was the cause, so I just stopped with everything. I started using a different moisturizer, which also ended up being a disappointment. But then I started using it again, and it's not really a disappointment anyways. In the meantime, I started using this again with a hydrating serum. The serum, I know, is fine. It's a good serum. I saw Cassandra Banks, Cassandra something, skincare lady, say that you should mix this with another serum to make it work properly, because there's a lot of hyaluronic acid. If you haven't heard it yet, hyaluronic acid can hold up to 1,000 times its weight in water. So if you live in a humid climate, it will absorb all of the beautiful moisture into your skin. If you live in a dry climate, which apparently I live in, even though I'm like 8 kilometers away from the sea. I don't know, to me it just sounds counterintuitive. Either way, this bitch dried the crap. crap out of my skin, even while using it with a hydrating serum, which doesn't contain hyaluronic acid. But it just really... At first I was using just the serum, it was fine. I started using the serum with this. My skin got so dry again, so I'm pretty sure it's this. Got very dry, got even more pimples, and my skin got a little red and a little sensitive a few times after using this. So it just really sucks. No, I really had high hopes for this and ended up really messing up my skin. And like, I'm not even halfway through. I have the whole packaging left. I don't know what to do with this. I would love to give it away to someone, but I don't want to ruin someone else's skin. Next, I have this moisturizer from Lush. It's called Enzymion. Let me read to you what it claims to do. Restorative and mattifying. The enzymes and alpha hydroxy acid remove dead skin cells and help to stimulate and brighten your skin. It's soothing, softening, moisturizing. It makes your skin plump and supple, reduces the appearance of scars, and it calms and protects your skin. That's a lot. That is a lot of claims. Yeah, where do I start? It didn't mattify my skin. It didn't moisturize my skin. No, honestly, after the whole time that I was using this, I have noticed basically no suppleness or softness or moisture. I don't know if it removed any dead skin cells. Can't tell you, you know. It wasn't plump. Didn't notice any reduction of scars. My skin was as red as normally. Didn't make it any softer. It basically did nothing. Absolutely nothing. I could cleanse my face, get this moisturizer, put it on my skin, and nothing happened. For the whole time, I used up the whole packaging and it did absolutely nothing. Not even moisturize. It didn't even moisturize, and it is a moisturizer. All of those benefits are supposed to work because of the fruit extracts and oils that they add to it. And the chemical compounds that are in these fruit extracts are not in very high concentrations. So there's a very small chance anything will happen. Like, it has a lot of ingredients, you know? So no fruit extract is in higher concentration. So no high concentration of the active ingredients. Also, I've read somewhere, I think it was on the Lush website, that it is supposed to reduce your pimples. Didn't do that. I literally did nothing. Huge disappointment. Huge waste of money. Do not recommend this. It does absolutely nothing. Then, think I saved the best for last. And look, I've used this a few years ago, like a long, long time ago, and I loved it. That was back when I did nothing about skincare, and I just tried to get rid of my acne with anything without honestly doing much research. So I've been using this cleanser. It's the Clean and Clear Morning Energy Skin Brightening Daily Facial Wash. It is all free, it has bursting beads. It wakes you up and brightens your skin with lemon and papaya extract. Let me tell you, it does wake up your skin. I think there's one positive thing I can say about it, and that is that it felt nice on my skin. You know, it was stimulating and it woke me up. I was feeling very fresh. And back then I was thinking, yes, it's working, I love this. And it smells very nice, you know, it smells very nice. Meaning it has a lot of fragrance. And as you can see, hopefully, it is very yellow. And it's very shimmery. Meaning a lot of colouring, a lot of shimmer. Which are not very good for your skin. And it has some beads. Some plastic beads, which are supposed to exfoliate. To be honest, I don't think they do a lot. I haven't told you why it's the worst product yet. Let me just quickly go over the ingredients. So SLS, you might already know that it's very drying and not very good to use on your face. The sixth ingredient is citrus, lemon, fruit extract. I'm pretty sure that citrus extracts are very irritating to your skin. Menthol. That is what is waking you up. That's why it felt so fresh. That's menthol, which is highly irritating. Perfume, limonene, linalool. So basically, this contains a lot of fragrance, colorants, shimmer, and plastic beads. Meaning the only thing it does is irritate your skin and kill fish. So yeah, don't recommend this. That will be it. Those were, like, really some of the worst products I've used. Let me know your worst skincare products in the comments below. I would love to know what to avoid. Be sure to like this video if you enjoyed and to subscribe if you want to see more. Bye bye.